decided to face me directly.
I won't let you harm her again.
You can barely stand.
Yet you're still afraid.
Simply dealing with a pest.
No!
Your mental defenses are not enough to protect you.
I will stop you!
You are too weak to move, let alone defend yourself. You have tried to defeat me, but there is nothing you can do now, you pitiful man. No final words? Or is even that too much for you to muster? This is the end, Doctor. Prepare to die!
No!
Doctor!
I'm still here. Still fighting on.
You are stronger than you appear.
Those are quite deceiving. At heart, I'm an agile, boundless young spirit.
Your suit, though, is ruined.
So what if there are a few scorch marks? I can always get it replaced.
Assuming you can even get up.
Fair point.
I'll help you.
No, stay back.
But
I'm not letting you put yourself in the firing line, young lady. Absolutely not.
You really think you can take all of my attacks alone?
Ah!
I ain't leaving you, not to this.
Your loyalty is a valued treasure, my dear.
She is small. She will not be able to withstand anything more than one shot.
Try me.
You both have a lot of fight in you. Shame nobody else can see it.
Ah!
What are you to attack a child? A defenseless child? Despicable, utterly despicable.
Doc, I'm okay.
Yeah, we can help each other.
Together, you think you stand a chance?
Together, we can do anything.
I could threaten to kill you both, but the human is already dead. Though I suppose that is something of a moot distinction, because I can still inflict pain upon what remains of her. I have downloaded her mind. Her very essence, and that is where pain lives. So long as she is a part of me, she exists. So long as she exists, I can torment her. You, Doctor, I can happily wipe from existence. You, I can kill.
This is the end. So close. So close to stopping you.
The Laringa are the natural rulers of the cosmos. You never stood a chance. One final blow to deal with you both.
Except now that I'm here, I doubt that'll cut it.
Maria? But...
I returned to the house. Reversed the ritual.
Linguistic replacement? You got it to work.
I couldn't claim to know what that means. I simply repeated what had freed me from this place. That couple saying those strange words pulled me out of this strange world.
Words have an immense power, my dear. And with the Loringa here, it isn't a surprise that this has happened. But to get back, well, that was a stroke of genius. Well done, Maria.
Simply another target for me to aim at.
Oh, I've had enough today. Whatever you are, you cannot intimidate me further.
Miss Baxter, if you could help us up rather than provoking the creature, that would be useful.
Of course, Doctor.
How are you limiting my influence?
Mariel's recent experience with transgressing the metanormative boundary has augmented your mental acuity.
Say what?
Coming back has made her mind sharper. She can hold the Laringa's attacks off for a while.
I can feel the strain already. How long do you think I'll be able to muster the strength to hold that foul creature back?
I don't know. We don't need all that long. Not anymore. I've got the final two people in need of rescue with me right now. The end is in sight, and it looks like we're going to win.
You're sure this'll work?
I don't exactly have a better idea. Do you?
We'd best try it then. Here comes one of those things. Yeah! Take that!
Ha! Hit it harder!
I'm trying!
It's running away!
Of course it is! Anything would if it'd been attacked by two angry people armed with spades and pitchforks.
Yet somehow it barely seems to have been affected.
I don't know. Seems a little slower.
So what? We keep doing that? Chased after the little blighters?
I don't know if that'll be enough. Caught anything more dangerous in that shed of yours?
This is an allotment, girl. What do you expect me to have? Axes? Pistols?
They'd be useful right now.
Well, I'm fresh out. Unless they're allergic to purple podded peas, then I don't have anything else we could use as a weapon. We've dealt with a few, but that was more luck than judgment with those things running into my animal traps. Good thing I was looking for a saboteur on the allotment.
But that hardly helps us now. They're learning to avoid them.
And we can't herd these scuttlers. It won't work.
Then we hit harder. Even harder. Look, another one is coming. Use that pitchfork. Try to pierce its armor.
Oh, it's no use. The armor is too thick.
Let me have a go. Look, a scratch.
Barely. We need a better plan. A more successful plan. Not just chance. This is taking too long. The doctor is counting on us, and I'm out of ideas.
We can't let Muriel down. Not my sister.
We aren't making enough progress. We're wasting time.
Think. There must be something.
Why do they have such thick armor?
To protect themselves.
Yes, but what if that means the flesh underneath is particularly vulnerable?
How does that help us?
That one you just hit. Where did it go?
It's over there, eating what's left of your vegetables.
Take the pitchfork. Hold it in place.
Okay. Got it. Oh, it's stronger than it looks. It doesn't want to stay still. Now what?
Fire.
The match. It's stuck in the scuttler's armor.
Look at it squirming now. Doesn't like the heat.
Listen to that. I think it's dying.
The flesh seems to burn well.
I'm excited. I just watched some alien insect die and I'm excited.
And shaking too.
This is terrible. This shouldn't be happening.
You're right though. This is exciting. We just made a difference.
There are still more out there.
You get them with the spade and I can burn them out.
Oh, can you smell that?
Try to block your nose. It's putrid.
It's the scuttler, isn't it? Oh, it's being cooked.
Burnt. It smells like burnt off meat. I've got some pegs in my shed. They'll help. Come on, we've got work to do.
You look like you're feeling better.
Because I can sit upright and hold a conversation without foaming at the mouth?
It does make a difference. Rabies didn't suit you, and you aren't yelling at me anymore like some rage-fueled lunatic.
Still feels like most of my energy has been sapped.
I much prefer calm, Antoine.
I think I do too.
At least I don't have to tie you up again.
I'm sorry if I scared you. I never meant to. To be honest, I don't really remember much after going into the sewers and getting attacked by that mutant thing.
Coming back to the house? Meeting Jemima? Going out again with Sally?
Doesn't sound familiar.
The stray cat we're taking with us when we leave.
How much of this are you making up?
Very little. Maybe.
It's good that you are making jokes. Things must be going reasonably well.
Not exactly. It's actually a lot worse.
Where's the doctor?
He got, sucked underground.
Right, you can stop with the silliness now.
I'm being serious. I saw it happen.
Just goes to show you I'm out of action for 5 minutes and he's struggling. Guess I best go help.
You're still too weak. Not that you'll admit it.
I'm fine.
No, you aren't. You need to rest. Here, have more tea. It helped before, so it'll help again.
I told you I'm fine.
You don't have anything to prove, Antoine.
Not to you, perhaps.
Now you're lucid and everything, I can go help. Oh, not this again.
An earthquake? In London?
The second one in as many hours.
That seems very unlikely.
Tell me about it. It's something to do with this alien thing that the doctor's facing.
We must be really close to the epicenter to feel it this much.
It's like we're moving.
Yeah, sure feels like it.
It'll stop in a minute.
You hope.
Told you. Now I'm going to see what I can do.
I'm coming too.
If you can walk, you can come with me.
Fine. I'll sit this one out.
You might not remember it, but you've caused more than enough trouble as it is.
If you say so.
I'll be back as soon as I can, and you'd better not have moved.
Yes, miss.
No need to be like that. Now do as you're told and stay here. Now I know what it's like to be the doctor. Hang on. We did move. We aren't in the allotment anymore.
Georgie, what's going on?
Stay there! Of course, the earthquake. We must have been dragged underground then. Wow, that shed is really sturdy. But what is this place? Looks like a cave, but... you brought us.
Yes, I did. Well observed. You are one of the doctor's companions.
Yeah, I am. Georgie.
Your name is meaningless.
You're huge.
You sound surprised.
I'm still quite new to this. This cave is huge. Bigger than a house, and you take up most of it.
What about that shocks you?
I'm really out of my comfort zone.
Do I frighten you?
That's one way of putting it.
Georgie, are you all right?
And that is the other one. The male. He was touched by my energy, but he is free of it. How is that possible?
Antoine is the impossible man.
I heard that.
What do you want?
To eat.
You wouldn't want to eat me. I'm barely a starter.
An appetizer, then.
More like an amuse-boucher.
Oh, definitely not the time for jokes. Look at the size of that thing.
Maybe it's overcompensating, trying too hard to be intimidating. Bark worse than your bite?
Maybe not the best thing to say.
Nonsense. We can take this thing on easy.
Look into my eyes.
Which ones? You've got 8, and they're all different. That's creepy.
It stole them from the people it killed.
And they're all looking at us.
It will be so much worse for you.
I'm inclined to believe it. Let's get back in the shed. Shut the door.
What good will a flimsy bit of wood do against something that size?
Buy us a second?
What good will a second do?
Well, when that thing decides it wants to eat us, it can have you first.
You aren't ready for this.
Nonsense. No time like the present.
My sentiments exactly, Doctor.
What's that supposed to mean?
I was feeling hungry and found myself a little snack. Your two little friends.
Don't you hurt them!
I wasn't planning on it. I don't play with my food. Just eat it.
We don't have any more time. Are you ready, Sally? It's your turn to be released.
As I'll ever be.
Thank you, my dear. There are no words to express how grateful I am to you.
Remember me?
How could I ever forget you?
I said you weren't ready for this yet.
Shush, Muriel! It has to be done!
Not by you, though.
Muriel! You can't!
Oh, but I have to. You're such a brave young girl. Far too young for all of this.
I just did what I could.
And we are so proud of you for that. Go now. Rest.
I ain't ready.
Be strong, Sally. I sincerely hope so. I do, my dear. I do.
She is free.
How did you manage that? The pain, the agony.
I had to release the child. I had to take pity on her. And you were too weak to get up.
I feel like I'm being pulled down to the ground. Like gravity is too high.
Like you're being weighed down by something unseen.
Exactly. Can you move? Even your fingers?
No. No, I cannot. I need a moment to rest.
We can't give up now.
Why ever not? It's poetic to fall at the final hurdle, Doctor. I don't even need to hit you for you to feel the power of my energy bolts. I can sense your fear. The fear of both of you. And it feels good.
What are we supposed to do? You're normally the one full of ideas. I'm here to make sure that the plans go smoothly, not come up with them.
Maybe we could swap things up today, then.
When there's a massive alien spidery thing looming at us in an underground cavern, I think now might be the time to stick at what we're good at. So if you've got something mysterious and ominous up your sleeve that the Doctor wouldn't approve of, or would have a series of questions longer than your arm about, now might be the time to say.
All I've got is stay in the shed.
Because that thing won't be able to get us when there's some plywood in the way. Are we really that desperate that we're hoping the big nasty monster is afraid of the big bad garden shed?
Well, I don't know about you, but I feel marginally safer here on the threshold. There must be something we can use in here.
The tea! It helped you fight off the energy from that thing, so maybe?
So we make the alien a cuppa, brew up some leaves and offer it a mug? Milk and sugar? You hear how insane that is?
I was going to suggest we throw the tea at it.
Other than perhaps a mild scald, I don't think that would work. To stand any chance, we'd need to get the caffeine into the bloodstream, and unless you've got a giant syringe...
Oh, I left it in my other coat.
And even then, the quantity we'd have to inject in it would be astronomical. And even then, for all we know, it could just get hyperactive from the buzz.
So then we do what the Doctor would. Bluff and bravado.
You first.
Right then. Yeah, I'll go and, can't do it.
Didn't think so, not that I'd have let you. Can't have you getting killed in some hollow venture. The Doctor would never forgive me.
So we just wait for him to save the day?
What was that?
It sounded like...
Help! Anyone!
People!
Jemima! Robertson! How did you get down here?
We were... dragged.
It felt like something was pulling us through the dirt.
But why? What does it want with you?
We were attacking those scuttler things. Muriel told us to.
Destroyed all of the rotters. Hope that did some good.
I wonder why it didn't try to stop you.
I imagine that's something to do with the Doctor. You know how it is. It's usually something to do with the Doctor.
But then, what if it's everything? What if, yeah, it's the Doctor, but it's us too. Jemima and Robertson with those scepter things, you fighting against the infection, and maybe Muriel doing something clever. And me just in the way. But that means...
It brought us down here for revenge, yes.
I think we're here for a similar reason. You know what's interesting? When you ran over to check on Jemima, that thing didn't seem to even notice.
How do you mean?
It might have moved that head thing, but it didn't seem to know where we are. The eyes aren't following us. They're static.
But I thought they were looking at me.
It's like a painting. There's only the illusion that you're being followed.
So we only thought it could see us.
I think it might be blind.
Wouldn't that mean that its other senses are heightened?
You mean it can hear us?
Yes, but there's a catch.
We're in a cave! Echo!
Ah, yes. The noise reverberates around the room.
An enclosed space means that tracking our footsteps is almost impossible.
The noises echo, making each step difficult to pinpoint. But how does that help us?
How did you destroy the scuttler creatures?
We set them on fire. We cracked their shells, the armor, and threw matches inside.
Fire! That's it!
So we do the same with this giant thing?
Seems like a solid plan.
Lucky I was clinging onto my spade when I was dragged down here. See how you like this?
Robinson!
Oh, that was probably a bad idea.
Rather premature, I think. It might not be able to see, but it can certainly feel.
Is he okay?
A couple of bumps and bruises, but I think I shall be fine. Thank you for your concern.
You've got Jemima looking after you. She won't let anything bad happen to you, Robertson.
Is that why she's blushing?
What have you got there, Georgie?
The doctor's gas burner. One up from a match.
And as much as my little attack might have hurt more than it...
Look! You dented the armor!
Quite a sizable crack. Well done.
Aim for the flesh inside. It burns remarkably well.
Let's hope my aim is good.
Good shot.
Seems like that hit the spot.
What have you done?
Stopped you. I'm sorry, but this is going to hurt.
Stop the flames! Stop the fire!
It's spreading too quickly, and it's trapped, burning away under your armored skin.
No!
This almost feels cruel.
Better than letting it eat the planet.
Why has it not attacked us yet?
Something is wrong. Can you smell that?
The landscape. It's melting away.
It smells like smoke.
Is this place on fire?
And if you look carefully, squint almost, you can see the cracks in this plane of existence. The Ringa is dying.
And what does that mean for us?
We're dying too.
No. There has to be a way out.
There is. Of course there is. There always is.
I'm dead, though. It killed me.
You created a body to exist in the real world before. You could do the same again. Just concentrate, Muriel. You can do this. I have faith in you.
I can see it. But the bonds. We cannot escape until they're gone.
So, you give them to me.
But then how will you get away? Who do you pass the bonds on to? But you'll die!
No. There's another way. Like shedding a skin.
But you aren't a snake.
I'm not human.
I know. But how?
I trigger a regeneration.
What does that mean?
I die. This version of me dies and I become someone else.
Like reincarnation?
If you will. It should release me from any ties to the Loringa.
You'd kill yourself to save me. That's suicide.
I prefer the term self-sacrifice.
I cannot let you do that.
What alternative do we have? My death is the only way that we can survive.
The body. The form I would inhabit. It wouldn't survive on Earth without the influence of the Loringa. Would it?
Honestly, no.
You mean to take me with you? In your alien spaceship?
My TARDIS could sustain you, yes. We don't have time to argue, Muriel. The flames are becoming stronger. If we don't get out now, we'll be smoked out. Give me your bonds.
I can't let you. I've already died. I've come to terms with that.
And if you stay here, you'll take on the bonds and feel the pain of dying again. And I refuse to let that happen.
Then we'll both die here.
Why are you being so stubborn?
Because this world of yours horrifies me. Because I don't want a future stuck there. I'm sorry. I do care for you a great deal. I can tell that you know this already. But I could never live like this. And I appreciate that you could never live a life with me. You aren't the type to settle down, to play backgammon with me and tend to your plot on the allotment. This was just a holiday for you, wasn't it? A short break. You weren't expecting any trouble. No alien threats. Just a little time to yourself. You weren't expecting some human to...
Maria?
Or for you to feel the same. At least I hope.
No! I don't want to leave you!
Goodbye, my love.
Maria!
Goodbye.
Doctor? Doctor, can you hear me?
Doctor! Doctor? Is he breathing?
Just about. Help me drag him clear.
It's burning down.
It's a husk falling apart.
He got out just in time.
Maria. Maria.
He's waking up.
Oh, she pushed me out. Maria saved my life.
Where is she?
What did she save the world?
No. No.
Come here, Jemima. I'm so sorry.
Doctor, where are you going?
Oh, you have got to be kidding me.
Where did the shed go?
Nowhere. It's exactly where it was. The shed was the TARDIS all along.
But we were inside.
He must have connected a different room up front to the doors. I didn't think the chameleon circuit worked.
I rerouted the power from the central column, overcame the flaws in the circuit, but it meant that we couldn't go anywhere for a while, drained us dry. I wasn't entirely sure things would reboot.
You risked stranding us here?
I was fairly sure there'd be a way around it. Either I'd come up with something or Antoine would. You know what we're like. Quite a resourceful bunch.
Why did you do it? Transform the appearance of the TARDIS at such a cost?
To prove that I could. I wanted some time to myself, to think things through.
Typical. It's because of me, isn't it?
Yes, Antoine, it was. You refused to answer any of my questions, to tell me who you actually are. You're hiding so much from me, I can tell I'm not a fool, and I'm sick of it. So yes, I wanted some peace and quiet to figure out precisely what to do about you.
And did you come to any conclusions?
Get in the ship. We're leaving.
No arguments from me.
You too, Georgie. Keep an eye on him.
Bye, Jemima, Robertson. All the best.
Is there a way out of here?
Down there. It leads to the sewers. 5 minutes, and you'll be on the bank of the river.
My sister
was one of the greatest people I've ever had the pleasure of knowing. She will never be forgotten.
Thank you.
No, thank you. You saved the world. You both did.
And now we go back to the rest of our lives.
I imagine things will be somewhat different now. Best of luck with everything.
We'll be all right. Don't you worry.
We should talk.
What about? Fancy a book recommendation? The libraries are full of first editions.
I need you to be serious for 5 minutes.
Time is relative, especially in a time machine.
When you were ill, drifting in and out of consciousness, you said some things.
Nonsense, most probably. Nothing to worry about.
You talked about our future.
I'm not clairvoyant, Georgie. If I was, I'd have done a lot more to avoid pretty much everything that happened to me here.
But you seemed so sure. I wanted to ask you, to get you to clarify some of the things you said.
I was delirious. I don't even know what I said. Hopefully nothing about peak elephants. We don't talk about that, not anymore. Those escapades I had with the doctor before we met you were a little on the unpredictable side.
You said you know where we're heading.
I haven't set the controls. Only the doctor can do that, and not all that well.
No, I don't think you meant it like that. Not physically, but...
I really don't know what you're getting at.
You do, though. You can feign ignorance all you like, but I'm not stupid. What are you hiding from me?
Some things are better not known. Don't tell him. He'll only worry.
Doctor?
Yes, my dear?
I'm sorry.
Me too. I'm sorry. I know I never stay long. But this time... Oh, it's all a bit too much. I don't think I'll be back here for a long time. Far too many memories. Why must there be so much death and destruction? Why are there so few happy endings? Is that really too much to ask? I'm sorry, Muriel. Sally. You deserved so much better... You were such wonderful friends, and had things been different, perhaps we could have travelled together for a time. I suppose it would have been rather crowded in here, but what with Georgie and Antoine too, but I'm sure you still would have left me. I do wonder why you stop yourself from getting too close to them, Doctor. No more tears. No more sadness that way. There are worlds out there where the sky is crying, where the trees fall in love and the rivers sing, people made of hope and cities made of sorrow. Somewhere there's beauty, somewhere there's horror, and somewhere else the tea's getting cold. Wherever we go next, whatever that might be, there will be no more death. That is a promise I make to myself, and will not watch another of my friends die. I am the Doctor, and I say no!